Hey guys, it's Mike from the Geek Pub. And after the last episode with the CNC fail, a lot of you guys have asked, is there ever a place where I would use the CNC to make the workload in my shop better or easier? And the answer is absolutely yes, when you're doing complicated, intricate work. And so with that, I have made a project for my grandson. This will be for his Christmas present, and it is 3D wooden alphabet blocks carved out on the CNC. So stick around and I'll show you how we did it. Okay, well, the first thing we're going to do is cut out the blocks. And I've got this piece of 1.5 inch by 1.5 inch poplar, and I've set up a stop block on my table saw sled at 1.5 inches, and that will make us a 1.5 inch square. Now, after I make these blocks, I'm going to come back and I'm going to straighten them up, probably using the fence or either the sander, I'm not sure. We'll decide in just a minute. But the reason why is, and it'll make more sense when you see it, but we're going to put these on the X-Carve to carve out each face, and we want to make sure that they are the exact same height no matter which face we put down against the bed of the X-Carve. And that way we can reuse our home position over and over and over, and that will make things go much faster. So let's get started. Okay, so much like I expected, when I measure them with the calipers, I get 1.56, 1.52, 1.49. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the smallest of that dimension, I'm going to set the fence, and then I'm going to use the micro jig to cut them down to size so that they're all 1.49. Okay, so I've set up a little jig on the X-Carve, and this allows me to add and remove blocks without having to adjust the clamps or work with double-sided tape every time. And that way I know that I'm going to get my cuts right every single time. And basically it works just by sliding the block in and then tightening up a couple of screws. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is paint all of the letters yellow. And once the paint dries, I'll hit them with the orbital sander and it will leave it with a really cool 3D look. So now I'm going to take each of the blocks and I'm going to run them up against the orbital sander. And this will remove the paint from all of the high areas. And to finish them off, I'm just going to shoot them with some spray lacquer. Well, this is one of those projects where I feel like the tool was perfect for the job and I had a lot of fun doing it. Now, you could certainly do this on, say, for example, a scroll saw and cut the letters out individually and just simply glue them on top of the blocks, but I don't think that would be near as fun. Well, hey, if you liked this video, I've got another video coming up that will show what we do with these blocks And you don't want to miss that one. So see you in the next video.